边那个放很多椅子，那边那个桌子下面。
I assume my number of us are above 40. And you're above 40, you find that you can see near. This is what we call press binocular. By the time you are 60, 70, the lens will turn down to 8, and this is what we call cataract. So let's go to press binocular. In the Chinese word, we call it 老花. So press binocular begins at around the age of 40, when the people experience blurred vision, you find that you can't see near anymore. You have to extend your arm as long as you can to see the words. What happens? It's actually because of the lens, our natural lens becomes hardened, loses reflectivity, and therefore light cannot be focused. In a young person, before the age of 40, you find that your lens are able to go far, able to focus more near. So by the time you're 40 and above, you find that your lens can focus more far, therefore you cannot focus more near. So this is what happens in press binocular. When you are looking here, the light focuses beyond the retina to the back of the retina, therefore the vision becomes blurred. So therefore you need a pair of reading glass in front of it to focus the light onto the retina. And this is what you see when you're age 40. So there are various ways of correcting press binocular. One of it, the most common one, is using spectacles. You either use the reading spectacles, or you use the bifocal or multifocal. In fact, there are a lot of people who wear multifocal from the lens too. Or the ultimate one, there are people who actually go for surgery to correct the press myopia. There are various ways to correct press myopia. Either using LASIK, CK, and a few others are very technical tools.
What else do you want?
The other natural healing process is cataract. So this is cataract. You find that the inside of the lens becomes a bit cloudy. It is not the outside of the cornea. Quite a lot of people has a white rift around the cornea and they thought that there is cataract. That is not cataract, okay? That is something else. Cataract is inside the pupil. What you can see, some very white ones and some very immature ones. So what do we do in cataract surgery? Most surgeons in KL, in Malaysia, nowadays we do what we call phacal emulsification. The method is not a small incision surgery. It is done at a daycare. It is coming for about 2-3 hours to either a hospital day or some practice to do it in a short place. The surgery lasts about 20 minutes or 30 minutes.
我看他在前面就是好像一直左卷的，所以我就站去后面。
All that you need to do is put your eye in a relaxed position, look straight to the eye, and the surgeon will take you for the surgery. This is what you see. We take a probe and we loosen the lens metal. And after the surgery, after the insertion of the lens inside, this is what you see, only a small little line at the edge of your cornea. Can anyone recognize what is this? This is what we call a fake glasses. Long ago, 30, 40 years ago, before the invention of this lens implant, after the cataract surgery, we just remove the lens. We don't replace another lens inside. So how can the patient see? The patient use these spectacles to focus the light. So the spectacles is very heavy and very ugly. In fact, at times, we still have patients come and tell us, doctor, after lens, after the cataract surgery, we don't want to have any lens implant inside. We are scared of having some foreign wash inside our eye in case it pops out. I think if you do not want to put this one inside the eye, you will end up this pair of spectacles, which is really, really ugly and very, very inconvenient, and you can't really see well in this kind of spectacles. So nowadays, I'll tell the patients, if you think that you don't want to put it in, I will still put it in for you.
Ages, so the quality of the lens and just bare age is very good.
The most commonest one, or the option one is you focus the right side for far, also focus the left eye for far. Just like any normal people who do not wear glasses, you can see far. Therefore, you need glasses for near. And there are certain people who actually love to read so much that they say, Doctor, I just want to read. So therefore, this application, we actually focus the right eye for near and also the left eye for near. So this is what we call, so this patient will wear spectacles for far. So when they are reading at night, they just take off their spectacles and they can read very well. However, for many years already, this we have been doing, call this a mono vision, where we will focus the right eye, which is the dominant eye, to see far, and then we will put the other eye to see near. So that means your brain will know how to choose your vision. You take one eye for far, one eye for near, but when you open up both eyes, you can see far and you can see near. But each time, you are actually seeing just one eye only. You will get headache, yes, you may get headache for the first couple of weeks or months, but after a while, get used to it. So this is what we have been doing for patients with uses monofocal lens implant. Now, go to toric lens. This is a toric lens, one of the companies, where there is actually some markings on the lens to see which direction we want to go. What do you mean by toric lens? Toric lens is a lens which we use to correct the astigmatism. So if your cornea is actually in this certain shape, you turn the lens into the opposite shape so that at the end of the day, the vision for your distance will be sharp. So it is suitable for those with moderate eye astigmatism to give a sharp vision at distance. So therefore, for near, you still need to wear spectacles. Now, I'm going to go through the multifocal lens implant. This is one of the multifocal lens implant. You notice it, there are some rings on the lens implant itself. You have some pattern. This another part where there's a ring, bigger ring which you cannot see. So this is one of those focal which they focus the light in certain area for far and certain area for near. So what is multifocal lens implant? It has recently been introduced and a few of the lenses has been approved by the US FDA board. We call this category of lens as premium lens implant. It has two focal points, one for far and one for near. It splits the image, half of it for far and half of it for near, using wire through the small tube that you have. And it is actually very expensive. It costs in the range of up to 3,000 ringgit for the implant itself. Compared to monofocal, which is a few hundred. Material is also the same. It's mostly acrylic. Can be chain piece, single piece, or in plate form. the facial first. I see what is the lifestyle. Are they a salesman? Are they a taxi driver? What kind of business do they need to use? Are they office worker before? Do they do a lot more reading? Or do they do a lot more driving? If I see a taxi driver, I see a salesman, is reading a problem for you? Is it no? If I need to read it, I just need a pair of spectacles. I think yes, okay. Can just go for no photo to find that money is a problem. However, if you are an office worker before, we actually work and sit in front of the computer most of the time. We actually observe, we have proper activities, and we do not like wearing glasses. I say, if you think that you can afford it, why not go for a voucher phone call? Especially nowadays, who doesn't use handphone here? Okay, everyone uses handphone, okay? Handphone rings are so small and they are more colored every day. And everyone don't want, when the phone rings, okay, even if they call, I can't see who is actually calling me. I want to press the number, I can't see the number. Those are very, very inconvenient for many people. So everyone wants a multi-phone nowadays, if everyone uses handphone. So, we talk about the vision, far, near, everything. Then after that, I also explain to the patient about the contrast, whether you use it maybe for reading newspaper. Talk about handphone, which is actually very, very colorful nowadays. And then we talk about computer, which gives you a lot of lag. And then we talk about the lens. Since I mentioned to you earlier, we are a lenses company that is actually by the lens has what we call diffractive qualities. Some of them has refractive qualities. Why are all these things different to us? Because we talk about near vision, we talk about clarity here, we talk about intermediate here, and we talk about intermediate vision, and we talk about far distance. Currently, there's no lens that can actually provide you from 1 inch to 8 inches. We are still at the level where we can provide you very near, very, very far. Intermediate and of course right in very far. So you will have to tell me first what kind of positions that you need and what kind of your routine in life that you're going to, so that I can help you to choose what lens. The multifocal itself, okay, can give you a near vision, far, it has multiple things, far near, far near, far near, far near, like that, depending on your size of your multifocal. This is one of the diffractive ones, where there's multiple steps on the lens itself with alpha, so that it gives you a different level of focusing point. This is what we call multifocal lens. So as I mentioned earlier, what is an ideal multifocal? Everyone wants a lens that can see all distance, far, intermediate, and near, under all lightings, bright, dim, and dark. The difference is that, you know, under bright light, when you're reading newspapers, you can see. But when you are in the restaurants where, you know, they leave it a lot, you can't even read your menu. So there are different lines that actually provide different kind of qualities also. And then talk about minimal aberrations, when you're driving. You find that street lights that come along, traffic lights that come along, at times you can see your glare also. And also on the certain side, we want it to be convenient for us to design the lens. So this is an ideal multifocal lens. So, as I mentioned earlier, who will actually benefit from this multifocal lens implant? Yeah. Ideally, I say I give it to all young patients if possible. Why do I give it to the elderly patients? Well, to me, in this part of the world, we can afford it. If you're 100 years old, so I'll give it to you. But you know, all those have to be sensible. Do not try not to spend so much money on it. It's also suitable for those who are actually working with real work. Examples goes to actually on operators, tailors, and the wiremen. Multifocals are very useful. Those who are with very low astigmatism, or you have very high astigmatism, then we suggest that you use the toric multifocal. And that, on the other hand, those who actually, as I mentioned earlier, who actually drive car, long distances, and night driving and everything, I do not advise you to go on multifocal. It is also not recommended for people who have actually retinal problems, near problems, because the multifocal lens will interfere with sharp images. Those who have glaucoma, any cornea problems, any nerve problems, all good. There are certain patients who have even unrealistic expectations. They want everything under the moon, they want to see the end, they want to see the cyborg. Those are the difficult patients that you try to find. So who are the good candidates? As I mentioned earlier, the easygoing one with actually realistic expectations. Willing to accept a new trade-off. Remember I mentioned about the contrast? And at the end of the day, what I tell the patient, what you're going to have is a functional vision. I'm quite sure you need to see your handphone, you want to be
visible,
you need to drive easily. On the other hand, you say that, doctor, I want to be able to put the thread through the needle. I'll say you need some additional help with your specialists. Multifocal lens grant is not the best, really, because it has a few disadvantages also. Remember the rings I showed you? It can actually cause some glare when you are driving at night. The headlights are coming to see about 3-4 rings around it. And then the near visual vision, actually I mentioned earlier, is 30, like 40 for near and 60 for far, or 50 for near, 60 for far. You find that the eyes will get tired easily. So at the end of the day, though these lenses may sound so plain, and you say that it's a fantastic lens, everyone can see well at the end of the day, do we promise you everything? No doctors will ever guarantee you everything. We hope so, but we cannot guarantee it. So therefore, the odds without glasses are better if you didn't have it.